One of the things to be concerned about in terms of evaluating crop health, particularly corn health after a hailstorm, is to look at a number of factors that could affect the final yield. So final yield is really composed of a number of things, including plant stand count. And in this situation, when we're over 10 leaf, it's almost a one-to-one situation where if we're dealing with a 20% plant stand loss, it might be equivalent to perhaps a 20% yield reduction. On the flip side, if we're looking also at defoliation, that is by far and away the bigger impact in terms of the actual percentage on yield loss. So if we're at tasseling and we have 100% defoliation, we're looking at probably 100% yield loss because we're not going to put on any more leaves on a plant in this situation here. You have what you have in terms of leaf growth. It's a matter of those leaves salvaging. The other concern here, though, of course, is damage that would occur from stock breakage and other wounds from the hailstones, leading to bacterial infection and other types of diseases, and just lodging that would occur, and we get loss in terms of the field later on in the fall. But initially, the assessment has to be on stand count and defoliation both. In this situation, we're not quite at 100%, but in back farther into the field, we're close to probably 70 to 80% defoliation. So it is quite significant in terms of that less than 100% yield loss. There'll probably be some yield. The other concern growers have from time to time is, will we have enough pollen in the field to pollinate the silks that are out here? It doesn't take the whole field to have tassels to do that. Sometimes less than that can actually be the effect with that situation. So keep in mindful, you don't need all the tassels in the field, but you need some pollen for that to occur. So some of these fields will probably yield, but will be probably kept in situations if they're not zeroed out for hail insurance and evaluated later. With the way hail is, farther back into this field, to our west here, is a situation where there's much more defoliation and we have just stalks, and those particular areas would be probably zeroed out in terms of the farmer perhaps looking at other options. One of the concerns, if you are going to take the corn out of the field and if you're going to recycle the nutrients, is planting a cover crop at this point in time, oats or some other cover crop, where at least you can hold the soil through the balance of the year if no crop is going to be planted. So consider cover crop, and then finally consider weed control as options, because water hemp, other weeds, will be prolific in here. In soybean situations, there is an option to put down a pre-emergent herbicide, yet layer it over, depending upon the label at this late date. Those options become fewer, obviously, as in corn. So keep mindful of that. You don't want to contribute to the weed seed bank next year in terms of the field operation. But assess the overall plant health. Again, stand count, defoliation is primarily the big situation here, but also the impact that you're going to have in terms of lodging in the fall of the year. This particular section of the field that had hail damage was quite a bit more severe than the previous one that we looked at. In this situation, we are much closer to 100% leaf loss and defoliation. Also, we had quite a bit more damage from the hailstones in terms of bruising and damage not only to the stalk, but also actually to the side of the ear, which could translate into infection points for bacteria, etc. But also our canopy is quite a bit more opened, so certainly we have an opportunity for a lot of weed growth, the potential in a lot of these fields and those types of situations. So even if we have standing corn here in the situations with that and good weed control now in August, in the month of July, by the month of August and we get into September, the weed growth could be fairly significant in terms of that, particularly water hemp and other weeds with that situation. So, and again, in these field situations here, if these fields are zeroed out and the corn residue is taken off the surface, basically we want to do as a cover crop situation and weed control to be maintained in there. But with 100% defoliation, more than likely we're going to be in that 90 to 100% yield loss, even though with larger corn plants, we may not exhibit the amount of stand loss per se because of the size of the corn crops compared to smaller corn, where our more significant will be the defoliation and the stalk breakage and the subsequent damage that would occur later. later on in terms of that. So those are the components and things to perhaps look at, but certainly we have a lot of silk out here, but you see the problem we're going to have in here is that a lot of these silks will become unfertilized. We're going to have a significant lack of pollen in the field, so we'll have poor kernel set. There'll be some drift from nearby fields and situations, but it will not be very good kernel set in subsequently by the end of the year. In assessing corn health, one other factor that should be done from the start of the assessment would be what stage is the corn plant at. In some situations, corn may be suffering from hail prior to tasseling, and a lot of the decision making is based upon the number of leaves. Typically, in larger corn plants such as this, the first 5 or 6 leaves have been sloughed off. Then it would require a person to actually, perhaps in some situations, make that leaf assessment based upon the number of collars that are left on the plant. If slicing the corn plant straight through longitudinally all the way down to the base, the first expanded internode, that would be leaf 5. So typically the first 5 or 6 leaves aren't out there, so you have to count from that first expanded internode and then count the leaves up, and typically you're going to be in a lot of our hybrids probably at this point in time in the summer, a V16 for some of the later planted fields, but 18 to 19 leaves would be quite common, and then we'll move into the silking stage and then into the tasseling stage. So an individual's cornfield could be different. The defoliation and the yield charts will be different based upon that. So you really have to do a good job if you have a comparison in the field with normal corn that hasn't been affected and planted similarly in an affected field, so that you know the number of leaves at the time of the hailstorm.
Well, we're in a pretty heavily hail damaged cornfield in eastern Renville County, and the problem with hail is it opens up pathways for some diseases. A lot of guys are worried about, you know, should they put a fungicide on to help with those sorts of things. When you do have a hail event, most of those diseases that result are going to be bacterial. Fungicides won't work. Things like smut, common smut, Goss's wilt, you know, those are the ones that tend to, and some of the stock bacterial stock rots and ear rots are what tend to happen after hail, and fungicides have no effect. There's been university studies, a pretty good one out of Wisconsin and also another one out of Illinois, where they've looked at the yield response on both corn and beans to fungicides, and you know, the odds of getting a response are very, very low. So there's probably other ways to save your or spend your money. So we've got bruising on these plants, on the stalks, ears, that sort of thing. Those are all entryways for pathogens, but again, those are tend to be bacterial in nature. Fungicides aren't going to help. It's a tail's a tough thing to have to deal with.